Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me, Gert de Tief. And tonight we are doing another shootout, head to head between two of the peated whiskies. And for tonight we will be looking at the Ben Riach 10-year-old Curiositas. And I will be putting that head to head in the shootout with the old Ballantrown peated whiskey from the Speyside region. So I've already did a head-to-head with the Ardbeg Wee Beastie with the Ben Riach, and in that contest the Ben Riach did a fantastic job and won the competition. And I was thinking, is there something better than the Ben Riach? And I thought, well, so I do like the whiskies coming out of the distillery of Tomentel, and the old Ballantrown is one of the whiskies that they produce. So I'm going to do a quick head-to-head, match them up, give you a quick nose and tasting notes on both of them, and I'm going to pick my winner. So I'm going to start off with the Ben Riach, as you might know, and I'll put a link in the description on the previous video that I made of the Ben Riach, the shootout with the Ardbeg. I will also put a link in the description where I did the standalone review of the Ben Riach Curiositas. I do like the color. Just a quick note, it is bottled at 46% ABV. It is a peated whiskey, and it is from the Highland region. Non-chilled filtered, and it's natural color. All on the label, like Ralphie would say, the contract is signed and all the boxes were ticked. ABV, non-chill filtered, no color. So, a quick nose. I do like it. There was a reason that it was the best whiskey for me compared to the Ardbeg Wee Beastie. The nose is fantastic. So you get the light smoke, which I do appreciate. It's not that iodine-y hospital smoke that you get from the Islas. So I do get some of the light smoke. A fruity note, quite a lot of fruit coming out. A nice, more like a barbecue type of smoke, so it's like a savory, meaty type of smoke in it. A little bit of a caramel note. Also a little bit of an apple or some overripe pears. I also get a little bit of a light honey. And of course, the alcohol. It's not that strong at 46% ABV, but if you put your nose in a little bit deep, you do get that alcohol coming out quite strong. So quite nice. And a little bit of a dusty note that also comes in. So all in all, on the nose, for me, it's really nice. So on the taste, cheers. Yeah, it is bacon. Ham, nice savory hit that you get with the smoke, exactly like chewing on a piece of bacon, crispy bacon, with a little bit of a maple syrup on it. So it's nice, sweet, crispy bacon. There's a nice caramel or toffee type of note in it. So the sweetness of it. I still get the honey. So it's nice, sweet honey. Honey in the taste. Also a little bit of a floral note coming through. And then a little bit of oak spice coming in, but it's just very light oak spice, not making it overly bitter. Lovely one. I just can't stop drinking this one. This is, I think I'm on my third bottle already during the course of the last 2 years. So that says quite a lot. Do like it. So, Fantastic. So moving along, I do not have a big bottle of this one. I only bought this one a while ago just to do a quick review and a taste of it. So I do have a little bit left. And I do find these whiskies from Tom and Tell and the Glencairn series that they also have from the Glencairn distilleries that falls under the Angus Dundee distilleries. Quite nice, so I think this is going to be a good competition or good shootout. So color wise, nice golden color on a bottle. It is a little bit higher ABV, so it is bottled at 50% ABV. It is a no age statement whiskey. It is non-chill filtered. And there's no color added. So ticking the boxes again, unfortunately, but no age statement, but let's see what we can find. So on the nose, on the old band round, it is. Oh my word, that's nice. So it is not a lot of peat in it. In fact, I think this would have been the first, I should have done this one first. Because compared to the Ben Riach, it's a lot less peat on the nose for me. It is quite a more fruity flavors, a little bit more sweetness, fruity sweetness like the apples and the pears also coming through. A little bit of a more like not raisins, but more a little bit like prunes. A hint of ginger coming out, definitely much more, well, a lot of vanilla notes coming out and some toffee notes. Fantastic. I will look at the phenol parts per million, but I suspect that it's going to be a lot less than the Ben Riach. So quite an interesting one. So on the taste, cheers. Okay, the alcohol is definitely at 50% ABV, much stronger. Even in the taste, it's got a little nice bite to it. I would definitely put a little bit of water on this one. It is quite strong. So the first thing that I get, the sweetness. I get the alcohol, a little bit of a peppery note from the alcohol. And this, on the second one, there's a little bit of a citrus note coming through, a little bit of a lemon flavor. Also remind me a little bit of a marmalade. So you've got a little bit of orange peel marmalade coming out. And now I get a little bit of the oak. And again, it's a little bit more oak than the Ben Riach, but it's still not overpowering and it is still quite balanced between the sweetness and the oak. The sweetness is there, the fruit are there, the apples and the pears are there. Now with the second sip, I get a little bit more of the smoke and it leaves me with a little bit of a dry mouth. So it's got a dry mouth feel. And it's quite similar to the aftertaste in the Ben Riach, is that way you also get that little meaty, savory bacon or ham type of aftertaste. Very difficult one. And this reminds me a little bit of a vanilla ice cream aftertaste. So picking the winner is, of course, it's not going to be an easy one if I compare the two. So the old Balatron, and on this hand I've got the Ben Riach. So nose-wise, now I get a little bit more vanilla on this one. And on the Balatron, it's a lot sweeter for me on the Balatron, Color-wise, the Balandra, which is at 50% ABV, is a little bit darker. Let me just take the glass like that. So the Curiositas is a little bit on the lighter side. Which is also strange, because if until versus no color, 10-year-old, and the Balandra is also no color added, and it's just also a little bit darker, but it is got no age statement. So on the nose, for me, I think it's quite I think the only big difference that I can get between the two is on the old Balandra, and I'm sorry if I mispronounce the word, but on this one I do get a little bit more flavor, and I think that is because of the 50% ABV compared to the 46% ABV. So, and it's also, I think if you agitate it a little bit too much, you get a bigger hit of all the notes coming out. This one is definitely deeper flavors, more flavors coming out, more vanilla coming out, more of a little bit of a toffee, raisiny notes coming out. So I have to choose one. I don't want to spend too much time wasting. I thought it was going to be difficult to find something better than the Ben Riach. I'm sorry, Ben Riach, but you have been eliminated. Absolutely, I think the old Balandra is fantastic. So, the shootout, cheers Balandra. I think you have just made the list again. And top of the peated ones for me, especially the peated ones from the Highlands and the Speyside region. I'm not talking the Islas. So, thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Cheers.